one thing that's most important about potato is if you can, you want to start with certified seed, and the seed is the foundation for a good crop, so you want to start with a healthy crop.
The biggest thing we do is we don't bring any potatoes on the farm. We start from tissue culture. Nothing ever comes onto the farm from another seed source other than the greenhouse.
Well, that's where we make sure that we know where our seed is coming from, what their seed program is, their state's seed certification program, just to make sure that what's coming in is clean before it gets here.
Plant from seed lots that are limited generation seed. That means they haven't been planted year after year from the same seed lot. When you're planting, you want to sanitize your cutting and planting equipment, particularly between seed lots. That way, if there are contaminated seed lots, you're not getting any cross-contamination. And before planting, you want to store your seeds at appropriate temperatures between 38 and 40 degrees Fahrenheit. In your storage, you want to maintain adequate airflow and levels of CO2. So when you're finally ready to plant your potato, you want to warm the seed prior to planting. The seed should be about the same temperature as the soil, around 50 degrees. One thing that you need to be aware of is there are certain potato varieties that are quite susceptible to the disease. So when you're using cut seed, you want to allow that seed to heal over, because once it's healed over, it creates a barrier and the bacteria can't actually get into the seed. You want to eliminate high drops so you can avoid bruising. Again, bruising causes openings in the tuber skin, which are areas for the bacteria to infect. You want to avoid hot water condensation on your seed, because that can promote low oxygen, and then again promote the soft rotting bacteria.